जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट आर एस फ्लिप फ्लॉप एंड इट्स वर्किंग देन करेक्टरिस्टिक टेबल एंड देन एक्साइटेशन टेबल। इन टुडे क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप। सो वॉट इज जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप? जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप इज ए रिफाइंड एंड इम्प्रूव्ड वर्जन ऑफ गेटेड एस आर फ्लिप फ्लॉप। तो वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इन दिस वन इज दैट जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप इज ए रिफाइंड एंड इम्प्रूव्ड वर्जन ऑफ गेटेड एस आर फ्लिप फ्लॉप। सो इफ यू नो अबाउट एस आर फ्लिप फ्लॉप देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप बेटर। सो बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू टू जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप प्लीज ट्राई टू लर्न आर एस फ्लिप फ्लॉप और एस आर फ्लिप फ्लॉप। It has been introduced to solve the problem of indeterminate state that occurs in SR flip-flop when both the inputs are 1. So why we have JK flip-flop? This is a very important question to understand. If JK flip-flop is similar to SR flip-flop, then what is the need to have JK flip-flop? Actually, JK flip-flop solve the problem of invalid state or indeterminate state when the value of SR R S is equal to 1 or R is equal to 1, that is set and reset is equal to 1, or when both the inputs are 1 1, then JK flip flop remove this condition. JK flip flop is named after his inventor Jack Kelvey. So why this is called JK? Because Jack Kelvey invented this JK flip flop. So after Jack Kelvey, this is called JK flip flop. In JK flip flop, input J behaves like input S of SR flip flop, which was meant to set the flip flop. Okay, so very important similarity between JK and SR flip flop, that is the input J behave like S, that is S is equivalent to J, and R implies to K. Okay, input K behaves like input R of SR flip flop. Okay, which was meant to reset the flip flop, and R similar to K. Now we can say that this is a, if this is a SR SR flip flop and these are the Q and Q bar. So this will be equal to J, just I'm going to denote it R and S. So this will be equal to K and this will be equal to J. Okay, so if why I'm changing this one, if you are making the SR flip-flop with the help of NOR latch, then R will be in front of Q and S will be in front of Q bar. Okay, so I just made it this thing. Okay, so got it. R is equal to K and J is equal to S. Now what else is different in JK flip flop? This is a construction of JK flip flop by using SR flip flop. So this is the, as you know, this is the NOR latch, or this is the SR flip flop with the help of AND gate. Already I explained this diagram in previous or SR flip flop under SR flip flop using NOR gate. So this is K and just K is equal to R. Okay, and this is equal to R and this is equal to S. Okay, just you can compare, rest is same. And this is the clock pulse. Okay, and the same clock pulse we had in the SR flip flop. The only difference that is the output Qn goes fed back to the input of K or AND gate. This is the very basic and very important difference. Similarly, Qn bar goes feedback to the AND gate. This is here, which will remove the condition of indeterminate of SR flip-flop. Okay, so just feel the difference. I'm just going to explain again. The only difference is this is similar like SR flip-flop. The only difference is that is feedback. That is Qn goes feedback to the input of AND gate and Q bar, like 1 2 1 2. Okay, so Qn bar is goes feedback to the input of second AND gate. Okay, now how is this work, or what is the truth table or truth table of JK flip-flop? This is important because without knowing you cannot understand the present state and next state. So I'm taking that is because there are three inputs, that is clock and then Qn. This is Qn and this is Qn bar. So the possible combinations of will be 8. That is the value of JK will be 0 0. That is we are going to 8 combination. Because Qn also work as the inputs. Okay, so let's see. 0 0, the Qn value of Qn, possible value of Qn may be 0 or 1. So for this 0 0 Qn is 0, for this 1 0 0 Q may be 1. Similarly, this 0 1 Qn may be 0 or 1. So each JK value Qn, possible Qn may be 0 or 1. So the combination goes to the 8. Okay, starting from 0 to 7. Now let's see if SR, this is similar, JK is equal to 0. Okay, JAK is equal to 0, then the next state must be the previous state, that is it will be 0 itself. Next state will be 0. If JK is equal to 0, JK is equal to, like as I have said, this is equal to SR. Okay, so you can compare the truth table of SR K. So if the value of SR or JK, which is equal to SR, if the value previous values Q, and then it will hold the same value. That is no change. Yeah, this is the hold condition. This is the hold condition. Okay, this is the hold condition. Now similarly, when the value of K is equal to 0, which is equal to R. Okay, so when the value of R is equal to 1, it will R is equal to 1, then it will reset the value. So if Qn is equal to 0, the next state will be 0. Similarly, if the next state is, if the present state of condition S is equal to 0, S is equal to 1, then it will reset. Okay. Similarly, in set condition output becomes 1. Whatever the previous input, output we have, it will become set. So if this is 0, then it will become 1. If this is 1, then it will remain 1. Okay. Now this was the uncontroversial conditions which we have discussed. But what's about when S is equal to R and R is equal to s is equal to 1 and r is equal to 1, or jk is equal to 1 or k is equal to 1. So let's find out, and I'm coming back on this one. When the value of jk is equal to 1 1, see, this is jk is equal to, j is equal to 1, k is equal to 1, and the clock is high. Clock is high, that's why your circuit is on. Okay, so in that case, suppose I am taking this condition when qn is equal to 0. For this possibility, I mean, in the first case I am taking qn is equal to 0. Okay, so this is 0. Now the output of qn is fed back to this one. Okay, just take it, this output is 0. So any input of AND gate is 0, then it will make the output 0. Okay, now this 0, if this is 0, then it will be 1. So it will 1 and this 1. Okay, this 0 and 1 is this 1, and it will inverse because it is NOR gate, then it will be, okay, so it will be 1. Okay, so any input, whatever we consider, if we will consider it in the next condition, qn is equal to 1, qn is equal to 1, that is this one, then the condition will be this one, that is jk is equal to 1 1, and this is 1 and this is 0. So let's verify it. This this is 1, this is 1, and this is 0 and this is 1. Okay, this is 1 and this is 0 and this is 1. So in this case it will be 1 into 1, when it will go XOR, then 1 plus 0 1, then it will be 0, that is, and this it will be 1. So what you are having, that is, your value is going to toggle. If this is 0, then it will be 1, this is 1, this will be 0. Okay, so this is called qn bar. If this 0, next will be 1, not this one. I must say this is qn bar. Okay, if this is 0, the next state will be 1, and if this is q and present condition 1, then it will be 0, and this is called toggle or complement. Okay, so it was the working of JK flip flop. This is similar to the SR flip flop. Only things, it removes the indeterminate condition of SR flip flop when inputs value are 1 1. Okay, so at 1 1 it gives the toggle value or complementary values. Now we can reduce this to table into this one, that is just 0 0. You can see that is both 0 0, this is 0 0, and output is whether 0 or 1, that is don't care. This is don't care, it may be 0 or 1. Okay, and in that condition, when j a is equal to 0, k is equal to, it will be the hold state or previous state. Okay, then when jk is equal to 0 1, whatever is the previous state, it will be reset, that is, it will be reset. And when the value of j is equal to 1, k is equal to 0, that is, it is equal to s is equal to 1. This is the set condition. Whatever is the previous value, whether 0 or 1, it will make it 1. And when the value of jk is equal to 1, 1, and does not matter what is the previous value, it will just complement the previous value. So it is the reduced to table of JK flip-flop. Now let's find out the characteristic equation of JK flip-flop. So with the help of this truth table, because by using the truth table we can make the characteristic equation. So just you can see where is the one in next state. So this is, these are position, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here at 4 places we have the 1. So by using the K-map between the JK and QN, we will find out the QN plus 1. So just mark the or map the K-map 0, 1, 2, 3. So at 1 we have the 1, at 4, 5, 6 we have the 1, then go for the pairing. This is one pair, this is one pair, and this is other pair. Okay, this is other pair, pair 2. Now reduce this one, Qn bar, that is 0, it is not going to change. Qn bar, and here what is changing? K is changing, J will be same. So this is the expression. And for this pair, Qn is not going to change because it is constant. So Qn is as it, and what is changing? 0, 0, 1, 0. That is Q bar will be same. That is this one. So this is the next equation for the next state. By using this one, you can make the logic diagram using gates. By using AND gate and OR gate. Okay, and now using the characteristic table, we can use the excitation table. So just check what is excitation table. Actually, excitation tables define the minimum required inputs for the present state and next state. So always we have what we want and what should be the minimum requirement for that state which we want to get. So that one, we have the present state, this is the present state, and this is the next state. Okay, because these are two Q and Qn plus 1, so possible combination 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 1. So what should be the requirement for 0 0 input requirement? These are the input. Excitation table tells the relation between the state, between the present state, next state, and required inputs. Okay, so with the help of characteristic table, we can find the excitation table. So where is the excitation table? This is the excitation table. So Qn is equal to 0 and Qn is equal to 0. This is one and this is the other one. Qn is equal to 0 and Qn is equal to 0. So what are the inputs required? 0, 0, that is 0, 0 and 0, 1. So in both the cases, J is equal to 0, and in this one, it will be don't care. So for first condition, J is equal to 0 and K is equal to don't care, that it may be 0, it may be 1. Now the second condition is Qn is equal to 0, 1. So let's find out 0, 1. So Qn 0, find out this one 0, 1, and the other one is this one 0, 1. Okay, so for that one you can find out that is in both the cases J is equal to 1, 1, and K is the don't care, that is 0, 1. So this is 1 and this is don't care. Similarly, we can find out for 1, just see 1, 0, that is 1, 0, 1, 0. Qn is equal to 1 and Qn plus 1 is 0. So just 1, 0 dekhiye. This is 1, 1, 0, and this is 1, 0. So in this one, you can find out that is J is changing and K is constant. So in this one, K is equal to 1, K is equal to 1, and J is don't care. Okay, similarly, we can find out for the condition qn is equal to 1 and qn plus 1 is equal to 1, 1. So, two pair will have, that is this one qn and this one. Okay. So, in this condition, qn is both the qn are qn and qn plus 1, 1. So, in this one, you can see that is k is 0 and j is 0, 1. So, this is the k is equal to 0 and j is don't care. And to make the excitation table, just reflect the inputs. Just try to find out if this is this is 0 and this is don't care, okay, then just check this is the this has the relation, and then if this is 1 then next value will be 1 and this will be 0. So they reflect somewhere in flip-flop. So if you find out one value or two values, so rest of two value you can find out, just you need to find out two values and rest you can copy from there. Okay, so it was all about the excitation table. So excitation table just tell the minimum required inputs for the present state and next state. So guys, it was all about the JK flip-flop, which removes the indeterminate condition of SR flip-flop. That's why this is helpful. Okay, in the next lecture we will discuss some other important topic. Till then, take care and have a great time.